Chapter 4, Quadratic Equations. Now let us move on to roots of quadratic equation. Now what is the meaning of this roots? Roots means solution. Solution of quadratic equation. That is to find out the value of the variable. Let me take one very simple example. Suppose if I have x square minus 9 is equal to 0. Now the variable used over here is x, and it is a quadratic equation because the power of the variable x is 2. Now if I want to find out the value of x which satisfies this equation, suppose if I put the value of x as 1, so if I put the value of x instead of x, if I put 1 in the LHS part, so this part is the LHS part, that is the left hand side. Now let me substitute the value of x as 1 in the left hand side. So I'll get 1 square minus 9. Now we know that 1 square is 1 and 1 minus 9. It is going to give me minus 8. But is minus 8 equal to 0? No. When I substitute the value of x as 1, I get the answer as minus 8. I do not get the RHS part. I am supposed to get RHS as 0. So let me substitute the value of x as 2 now. Suppose if I substitute the value of x as 2, then I'll get 2 square minus 9. We already know 2 square is 4. 2 square will be 4, and 4 minus 9 is going to give me minus 5. So again I am not getting 0. Let me move further. Suppose if I substitute 3, I get 3 square minus 9. Now 3 square is 9 itself, and 9 minus 9 is 0. So this time, yes, we are getting the RHS part. So in this example, we say that 3 is the root of this quadratic equation x square minus 9 is equal to 0. So we will say that 3 is the root of this quadratic equation, whereas 1 and 2 are not the roots of quadratic equation, whereas 3 is the root of the quadratic equation. Whenever I substitute 3, it satisfies this equation. So roots of quadratic equation means the value of the variable for which the equation gets satisfied, that is LHS becomes equal to RHS. Not only 3, I can also take minus 3 in this case, because I know minus 3 square is going to give me 9 again. So yes, 3 and minus 3, both of them are the roots of this quadratic equation. Now what you are supposed to remember is every quadratic equation has two roots. Why it has two roots? Because the degree of the variable is 2. Let us take one more example to get to know what are roots of quadratic equation. So suppose we have an example of x square plus 6x minus 16 is equal to 0. Now select any random value of x. Suppose if you select the value of x as 2, let me substitute. So if you substitute x is equal to 2 in the LHS part, just concentrate on LHS part, that is x square plus 6x minus 16. So instead of this x we are going to put 2, instead of this x we are going to put 2. So we'll get 2 square plus 6 into 2 minus 16. 2 square is 4 and 6 into 2 is 12. So 4 plus 12 minus 16, 4 plus 12 is 16 minus 16. That is going to give me 0. So yes, x is equal to 2 is the root of the quadratic equation. Because when I substitute the value of x as 2 in this equation, we get equal to RHS, that is 0. So not only 2, it will have one more root. Every time we cannot be dependent on this trial and error method by substituting each and every value of x. So there are some methods to find out these roots of quadratic equation. And always remember, every quadratic equation will have two roots.